Oh, it's time. It's time once again for the original pile driver to crack open a throwback. Ready? Let's count it down, brothers. 3, 2, 1, crush!
Okay, so yeah, that was the original pile driver, aka the original pile driver, crushing open a Pepsi throwback. It's got the real sugar. Let's go back down memory lane and remember what the throwback tastes like. Beats Pepsi. Pepsi throwback is better than Pepsi. And while I'm thinking about it, I got plenty of these dudes here. It's upside down, I know. I had a Pepsi throwback here. Pepsi throwback here. Pepsi throwback here. So I got plenty of throwbacks, baby. So, videos are coming. Some most throwbacks in one. I'm not gonna bang, bang, bang. No. I do the crush. Yeah. 12 lovelies. Okay, so, 10 a.m. packs. Oh, but before I get ahead of myself, I got a, it's morphin' time. Retro, talking about vintage. Found this yesterday, and I was out of town. I was over in Johnson City, Tennessee. Found this at the mall, and I had to grab it. One more, hold on. Yeah, never mind. Can't find it. Okay. So, 10 a.m. pack. This thing coming back. Next BA, dude, you were talking about how Sting came back and won the title and all this and this. And his, the glittery, shiny crotch piece. That was questionable. But the jacket thingy, that was more of a classic vintage Sting. And, I didn't really mind the jacket part so much, but the whole, I'm quiet. Sorry, guys. But, yeah, the jacket thing was alright, I think, but, you know, whatever. The whole point of Sting coming back was just, I don't know. I like Anderson. Anderson, asshole. Some people, I'm not going to name any names, XBA325, seem like Anderson shouldn't have the title. Well, you know, everybody has their opinion. But the fact that they gave it to him was one thing. And they took it away from him to give it back to Jeff Hardy to just give it back to Sting. Why? And is Sting going to carry on the butterfly title this whole time? I mean, come on. Seriously. Next week, of course, Anderson steals the belt from Sting and beats the hell out of him. Spoiler alert, delayed reaction, whatever. I don't really care. Because Sting and TNA is nothing. Sting and WWE would be money. Because of the fact that it's never happened. And WWE is a powerhouse. They are a huge corporate conglomerate who can crush anything in their path. So Sting will never be an entity in WWE. Cool, whatever. The promo, 3-3-11. As opposed to 2-21-11. A lot of you think, oh, everybody thought it was Sting and it wasn't. They're stupid. Well, originally, a lot of you don't know this. But let me take a sip before I go back. Let's see. 3-3-11 was a parody of 2-21-11, as you all can tell. Because of how exactly the same it was. But what a lot of you may not know is the fact that WWE did produce that commercial, that promo, the 2-21-11 promo for Sting. They had every intention of having Sting come back on 2-21-11 to WWE and confronting probably The Undertaker. But Sting chose to sign the contract to TNA, thus making the promo irrelevant And then they took The Undertaker and attached him to it, and that's where you got the 221-11 deal. Now the 3-3-11 deal in TNA a couple weeks ago, or a week ago, whatever it was to promote Sting, as everybody knew. Now, that promo that TNA did was a parody of the 221-11 promo because WWE produced it for Sting, and they did not get Sting. So TNA felt it would be funny to say, hey, look, we did. Ha, ha, ha. But see, it wasn't anything special for TNA because they've had Sting many, many times. He's been NWA TNA champion many times, and he has no need to have a special, like, oh, guess what's happening promo. And they didn't do it to promote Sting coming back. They did it because it was a parody of the WWE version, who stole it from, like, a movie or something. Thank you, Tommy Dreamer, for that tidbit. Yes, Tommy Dreamer direct messaged me on Twitter. Not that I'm anything special, but I asked him flat out. Because he's the only guy. I'll stand by this fact right now. I say this here and now. In the beginning, when I first started watching TNA, as it is, I talked to Dixie Carter on Twitter. I was always mean to her, saying TNA sucks and all this and that. And she would cry and ask me why I'm so mean to her. And, because I'm passionate about wrestling. It's wrestling. Not freaking The View and not damn Jersey Shore. Okay, it's wrestling. You got it? Professional wrestling. And what's Dixie do? Jersey Shore. Blah, 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 blah. Bisexual characters, whatever. Thanks, Orlando. Thank you. You killed Chris Canyon. I'm going to say it. Anybody, I'll get heat for that. I don't care. But anyway, moving on. Dun, dun, dun. Chris Benoit. Chris Benoit. Dun, dun, dun. Okay. Anyway, moving from the dark to the point. TNA, as told to me by Tommy Dreamer himself, and I could verify that by taking a picture and putting it in this video or in the next video, whatever. But Tommy Dreamer told me that WWE produced that promo for Sting. He did not sign. He went to TNA. TNA thought it'd be funny to have a 221-11 promo parodied by a 3-3-11 promo, because everybody knew it was Sting anyway. Everybody said, to all of you who said, Sting's coming, 221-11, Sting, it's Sting, it's Sting, they were right. They were absolutely 100% positively right. But Sting chose to not go that way. So they turned it into The Undertaker. So all of you are absolutely wrong as well. Regardless of the intentions, TNA thought it was funny to parody that. To say, look, you didn't get Sting. Ha ha ha. But that has to go on record as the stupidest. It's in here. This is the Guinness Book of World Records 2012 to 2013. It says right here. TNA doing 3-3-11 was the stupidest angle in wrestling. Right here. In the Guinness World Records. Right there. See? Guinness World Records. Stupidest thing ever. Now, Tommy, no disrespect. I like Tommy Dreamer. I'm a fan of Tommy Dreamer. Hold one moment. See this? It's a photograph. Tommy Dreamer. In my hand. Yeah, at a moment. I felt the extreme run through my veins, brother. A lot of people give Tommy crap because he was the pretty boy in ECW and he really never amounted to much. But I always liked Tommy because he made wrestling fun for me. Watching the old ECW, him and Raven, I mean, it was great stuff. And then him and WWE and everything. I love Tommy Dreamer. He's a cool dude. Okay? So, you know, whatever. You can hate him if you want. You can tell me I'm stupid for liking him, but I do. I'm not saying he's a good wrestler. I'm not saying he's the perfect entertainer. But I like him. Okay? And I'll trust Tommy when he tells me something. Because Tommy talked to me during the when they were planning the Hardcore Justice pay-per-view. And, you know, he's a cool dude. So Sting was going to go to WWE. He didn't. He went to TNA instead. Played off as a dumb, total bomb that didn't pull off. And how TNA got such good ratings for that show for their standards. not in general, but to their standards, they had a good rating, and it baffles me, to be quite honest. One more sip of the Pepsi throwback, and then we're gonna stop this video, post it on YouTube, brothers, and have a nice day. And if you smell what the Rock is cooking,